So it's a view from Long Room. This is the view all the way down. So I'm standing by the bar and that's all the view. They're just getting everything ready for tonight. And if I just turn around, there's the bar. Stocked up, ready to go. And behind me is the cooking facilities. This is the view from outside. It's a bit dark, but you can see the lights inside. You can't see outside at all, it's completely dark. Oh, look at that. I can see over there some Christmas lights flashing. But that's the view, so we can see the lights, top lights working. So this is the reception area with a big massive white Christmas tree. Reception desk, the fire's not on. Can't be burning any marshmallows or chestnuts tonight. So we look through here. You've seen this place a number of times. Big staircase. And this is the drawing room, which tonight is the restaurant, which is all laid out for anyone who wants to eat tonight. So if you remember the wine glass is laid out for a birthday party tomorrow. This room has been laid out for a birthday party for tomorrow, Sunday. And that's the back. I just go over here. This is the back of the bar where they built a kitchen. They built a kitchen area just there. That's the, behind that is the bar area. That's the kitchen. So yes, we've got a birthday party happening tomorrow. Nothing to do with me. I don't think they're having any entertainment here tomorrow. Just a birthday party. And they've got a sweetie bar. I'm thinking, oh, wouldn't mind a sweet now. So it's Saturday now, the 7th. This is the third day at Brown's Overhaul. This is the second day in this marquee. So just a run again for equipment. FBT's X-Lite 12s. I've got the LEDJ Tripex battens, Tipex battens, with American DJ Stinger 2 on top. The LEDJ Trimetrix cloth. And down the bottom I have a hazer. Now, I've just put this on for a bit. It's by Atmos Tech or something. I've had it for a couple of years, I hardly use it. Doesn't seem to make much difference really. I think there's a blower. There's a blower blowing the stuff out, I think. But so let's have a look, walk around. I did tidy up today because I had a bit of time. I put a mat there, that's a signal cable. And I put a mat here for the mains cable. It's all running around the back here. This I a bag there behind the Christmas tree that I can't see with my trolley. The cable's running there for the American DJ Mega Profile Plus, the Ultra Bar 10 I think it is, another American DJ Mega Profile Plus. They're mine, and you've got Mega Profile Plus is running all the way along here. They're by the guy who looks after the venue. Rubbish behind this Christmas tree again, you can't see it from in front. I've tied it up compared to yesterday because I had a bit more time. Again, I've put a mat down here on a mains cable and a mat on the signal cable. So it's a bit tidier. Of course, there's a signal cable going underneath. I've got three cables running there. Four, actually, two mains, two DMX because of the lights. I don't know, you can't see it. I could bundle them together, but, you know, but. But, so let me just straighten this out a bit. There we go. So these are the LEDJ Tipex or Tipex battens. Very sophisticated bit of kit. I don't use them that way. I only put them for sound to light. It throws out a lot of light on a dance floor. So look, got a nice Christmas tree here.
There's no napkins on here.
So the American DJ Stinger 2's here. They're just running on sound to light and Master Slave. That's a venue getting all ready for tonight. Got the tablet with some songs downloaded or copied onto an SD card. So, yeah, we've got a few more people in today. So, Yeah, the cables, don't look underneath there, please. You can't see the cables all underneath there. My 758 microphone's on the floor. I can see my Sony headphones. And this is the controller for the Hazer. So that's on. And if I press that, it's ready. I can hear it. I can hear it doing its thing. I can't see any haze. It's like there's a blower, heater blowers. If you can see the marquee, the tops are moving. So I think what happens is the blower is just blowing the haze out. Because if I come on the front here, in theory we should see something. Nothing. Oh, nothing. Because I think the blower's blowing it away. But anyway, so that's set up for today. Today's the last day here for this week. Back again next week. And I said, this is the mains cables. This is to feed in my Mega Profile Pluses. I tapped in over there to run everything else. I've used the mat that was here last night. I've just taped it down actually, and I put it on here to make it a little bit tidier. So anyway, that's that. So we're just taking a walk towards the equipment. It's only 6 o'clock and I don't arrive till 7. So we can look at the LEDJ Tipex or Typex patterns. They're on sound to light. When I've watched the videos of these things, they don't look as clear as they do in real life. I think it's too much glare on the camera, I think, but they do throw out a lot of light. If you see on the dance floor, they go for a sequence of patterns. The auto program is just random patterns. As I said, it's quite a sophisticated bit of kit. You can connect it to a computer and do some graphics on it, which is not my cup of tea. But I put the American DJ Stinger 2s. And I thought last night was the first, I think it's the first time maybe. I thought it looked quite effective. I thought it did a really good job. It hit the back of the wall, which is quite a distance. And obviously it does help when you have the fabric off a marquee, doesn't it? Lights look better. I filled the floor with the lights, the whole room actually, and the LEDJ battens, they give out a lot of lights. It's something slightly different to the norm, I guess. Each their own. Just there's a lot of cabling with it, so DMX and mains. So just going through a little patterns. I said when I watched it on the video, the glare's quite bright on the camera lens, so it don't quite look all right when you watch it back on the video. Once I recorded it, but just a little patterns. Maybe I'm too close. I don't know. But today's the third day of Christmas parties, and today I've got to take the equipment, pack it down, take it home. Now next week I'm only here one day because I'm elsewhere. Next Saturday I'm here, so and then thereafter. Actually, I probably could deal with where are we? Probably could deal with a couple of more uplights. I think probably the back wall could probably be uplit better. But I brought that the other day because I requested to do so. But the guy who looks after this hotel, that's his Mega Profile Pluses. He's going to bring a couple tomorrow to replace mine. But I think they need a little of a row there, really. That's my humble little opinion. And you can't see my rubbish behind the Christmas trees. I hid them better today. If I got an angle, you can. If I was sitting over here, if I was sitting in this seat and I looked over there, I can see my bag. But I don't want to put it in another room because it just means more walking around and delaying. Because what they do, like last night, I left some stuff in here and I have to put some other stuff in another room. But they're waiting for me so they can lock it up. So I didn't want to traipse in and out of the hotel. So all my bags and stuff are in this room today, ready to pack down for tonight. Yeah, there's four groups, two fairly large groups. One I recognise from the name from previous parties, the others I don't know. last night was okay. And I got them early. I think I got them too early last night. I got them what, before they had their desserts. So, but they all complained it was too hot because the heaters are blowing out and I'm standing by one. But these heaters are on from the morning because it's going to be cold. The blow heaters. Electric bill must be phenomenal. So much for the carbon footprint. So, this is just a lull before the storm. I've got my iPad out and I put some Christmas music on the SD card and used the iPad. And there's the LEDJ battens again with the LED StarCloth. As I said in a previous video, I had this for some years now, the StarCloth, and don't know what else to put in front of it really. I do have, and it does sort of, I do have Dequinox foldable screens, but I use them on bigger gigs, particularly for big weddings. But there's a close-up of the LEDJ pan doing its thing. That's the one we're looking at as a slave. And American DJ Stinger 2 is a slave as well. So all the cables are running underneath, underneath the stand, underneath there. There's a load of cables underneath there. And there's the hazer, which I haven't brought out for years because you can't use it anywhere. But what I noticed is when I put it on, these blower heaters, which are on my left, which is that way, are blowing everything this way. So it's actually not doing much, but it's plugged in now, so I'll leave it there. Dance floor, actually the dance floor was falling apart. It's an old dance floor with, as you can see, with damage on it. And they want to buy an LED one, but I would have thought they would have bought one by now. They didn't want to rent one because I got in touch with someone who deals with it and I gave them quite a good deal actually. But they didn't want to rent one. They wanted to buy one, but I think the floor lets the whole place down. All this is brand new. The carpet is not brand new. They're disappointed with the carpet. They're going to get a new carpet once this is all over and done with. They're disappointed with the carpet. Blue, I don't know about blue, but yes, so all the staff are around the back, behind that bar is a little kitchen area. Apparently I just been told that they've had their first noise complaint. Now yesterday was the first time they used the marquee, and one of the residents, well, there's no local residents, they're quite away, has came into the hotel to complain about the noise level. Now, you can't see because it's too dark. So, you know, they're worried about it now. But I didn't have it banging out loud at all, so see what's going to happen.